My piece is dramatic and it's called Another Piece of Sky. My inspiration was really just what I see going on with my friends and what is happening at school. And I started writing it in about October, but I really only came up with the main chunk of the piece the night before I auditioned. Mr. Rossi has helped me a lot in developing it, but in the original draft, one of my friends, Alex, had helped me come up with ideas and keep pushing through the general idea.
I think I've lost the sky, and that scares me to death. I think unconsciously, most of me has lost it too. It's like we're so caught up with keeping up our grades, living up to the expectations of our parents, of our school, even of this town, that we just kind of lose the sky. What I mean is, we forget to look up. Forget to look into the universe as we are, as children. Forget to dream. It hasn't always been like this, though. I remember when I was little, I could spend hours upon hours just looking up, planning out what I was going to do once I finally grew up. I think I've planned out my life as a famous cowgirl, the first astronaut on Mars, and even as Captain Dolphin, everyone's favorite dolphin and superhero. But it seems that I progress through my high school career, I'm losing this big dreamer attitude of mine. This school has given me, the girl with her head in the clouds, a reality check. And the sheer numbers of this school almost blow your eyes to begin with. I am one in a class of 1,400. One in a school of 4,500. Nothing I do will render recognition. There will always be someone better, someone smarter, someone who deserves it more. Always someone else. If this is true in high school, how is it possible I'll be worth anything in the real world? My beliefs that I can do anything are going right down the drain along with my dreams. This can't be healthy, comparing myself to all these people. Watching my precious sky just swirl away, it's got to be leading me somewhere bad. If you pay close enough attention in these halls, it's pretty evident that is what will happen. Because it seems when we stop dreaming, we start taking the physical world much too seriously. Never did I expect to see what I've seen, or to hear what I've heard once I really started paying attention. Hearing of so many with, in theory, the perfect equal lives, who are suffering. And these are people from every clique and every stereotype. Some people are just better actors than others. But everyone has their own way of dealing. Maybe it's Jack, who leaves school every afternoon, the teacher's pet, but arrives home the accident. The kid whose father tells him none too plainly he's not wanted. Who deals as any rational kid would. No, not by curling up with a book, but instead by staring up at his ceiling, allowing his retro boombox to lull him to his Vicodin-induced stupor. It's okay, though. He knows exactly how far it can go, even though this limit has been steadily increasing since last fall. For Jenny, who's never been a teacher's pet like Jack, but she knows her limits, too. Though her precisely placed accessories and fountain excuses beg to differ. Jenny has everything she could be expected to want. A loving family, good friends, average grades. Heck, she's even pretty. But she's never had to work for any of this, and it's all lost its meaning. So she'll continue to dig into her arms, hoping to find the reason she's here. Nicole has simply realized she doesn't care about her grades. It's always been tough for her to pay attention, but this year is just too difficult. And she's decided she's going to focus on learning about life. Too bad her parents don't agree. So she'll continue finding a new boy to sit with every weekend. And Mark knows that he will only be happy once he's accepted to Harvard, but his grades aren't in the right place. So he'll continue to starve himself till they are. And Carl isn't even looking for that level of perfection, but what if he starts losing hope? What if he allows his mind to respect those dark corners he's incessantly trying to avoid? What if, in one of these horribly hopeless moments, he finds his father's gun? What if, just like that, another piece of sky blinks out of existence. Another dream is forever washed away. Am I doomed to this? Are all of us? Well, you tell me. Now, I know I'm going to find my sky again. I know it's going to be tricky, and it's probably going to take quite a bit of time, but I will find it. It will happen. So, you tell me. Next time you catch a glimpse of the sky, what will you see?
I am planning to go to college, but I'm not sure where. I've just started looking, and it's a little bit overwhelming. As for a career, I've been looking into fields like environmental sciences and zoology, and there's also a chance I might end up teaching.